Okay. Oh shit. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Akanksha and I do fashion, beauty and lifestyle. People who are new here, blah blah blah, sorry. Retake. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Akanksha and I do fashion, beauty and lifestyle. So today's video, I'm going to talk about one of my experiences with how to get what you want in your life. It's kind of law of attraction. I don't really follow it a lot, the law of attraction, because it has a lot of flaws according to me, what I feel. But I'm going to share one of the things that I have experienced growing up when I was in school, when I was in college, and how like what kind of society I was in and what kind of dreams I had and how I actually am able to achieve most of them, if not all. So without talking much, I'm just going to jump into the video directly. So yeah, let's go. I'm going to start my journey from school. So when I was I was in 10th standard or maybe 11th, 12th, I was never clear what to do, but I always wanted to do something that matters and that can bring a change in the society, because the society I have grew in, it is perfect, it's wonderful, but a lot of things that I personally feel, you know, you are not encouraged to do what you actually want to do, because there are few norms which you're always following, like, you know, you have to grow up, you have to study, you have to be in top of your studies, and you know, a little bit of sports, and then you have to marry, you have to have kids, and then your life goes on. In that entire journey, sometimes we lose the grip of who we are, we forget what our passion is, and we don't follow our hobbies because we have a lot of responsibilities. We have society who is looking up to you, you have next generation who you have to groom and stuff like that, and there are a lot of expectations, and not only for a girl, not only for a woman, but for men as well. And this is what I have seen growing up. But luckily I have been in such situation where my parents were very supportive, if not relatives, but parents and my brother sister very very supportive. And now I'm not going to talk about like my parents were supportive and because of all of that I got where I am. I'm not telling I'm somewhere, you know, very big, I have achieved all of the things that, you know, I wanted. As I mentioned, not all, but yes, some of the things which I felt were not you know, going to be in my way and I will not achieve, I have achieved that. And honestly, there are few points I'm going to discuss about, but before discussing the points, how to get you what you want, there is a little story that you should listen definitely. And this story actually includes one person. She's like my friend. She was in college with me, and she have no idea that I'm talking about her here. But I hope if she's watching, then she will really love it. I was in college. I did engineering, and first 2-3 sems were really very tough for me because, as I mentioned, I'm an average kid. I'm like not interested in studies. I was always into sports or into something else. You know, in engineering you will get supplies, if you know what I mean. So I did get few supplies in my first second sem, and I was like okay at first, but then I thought, you know, not happening, I should just, you know, even if it is not something I am you know, aiming to do, but you know, now I'm in this particular field, I have to, you know, at least try my best. And then along with that, in my class there was a topper, her name was Ishita Jain. Whenever I used to see her, she was like me, a fun person, fun loving person, and she's always having fun. She's always trying to, you know, have fun out of every moment when I saw her, and she enjoyed her life like as long as I have seen her in college. And I was like, wow, this girl really inspires me, though I never told her about this, but I was really inspired because despite of the fact she's having fun, she's even bunking classes sometimes. I'm sorry Ishita, but yeah, that time we were kids and it's fun. But that time she was on top of her game. She was always like a topper in our class, she never got supplies, and that was like, for me it was like, you know, this is the dream. I want to have fun, but I don't want to you know, be a loser. I want not topper, but at least mujhe उस लाइन में आना है जहां पे आई डोंट हैव सप्लीज एंड आई एम इन यू नो अ सेफ प्लेस इन माय एजुकेशन सो दैट आई कैन कंप्लीट माय ग्रेजुएशन विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम. आई कैन कंप्लीट माय इंजीनियरिंग विदाउट एनी सेल्फ डाउट ऑन मी. एंड आई केम होम. सो एज आई मेंशन आई डोंट बिलीव इन लॉ ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बट आई हैड दिस थिंग फ्रॉम चाइल्डहुड. वट एवर आई वॉन्ट आई ऑलवेज हैव अ बुक लाइक अ कॉपी और अ डायरी. जस्ट कम होम एंड आई जस्ट विल राइट वट आई वॉन्ट. And to be honest, I am not going to lie about this that I did a lot of hard work. No, I did not do anything. I just wrote it. But I remember when I write something that I want on a copy or on a diary, it is with all my heart in it. Like I will write it like, you know, it's just I can't live without it. I want it. And then similarly, I came home that day when I realized, you know, I want to be like her, exactly like her. But, you know, when it comes to, you know, studies and when it comes to having fun at the same time, I want to be that kind of person. So again, I'm repeating, but I just grabbed a diary and I not a diary actually that time I just grabbed a copy and I still have that copy because I'm in my hometown because of the situation of corona and we're working from home. So I came home and my mom was, you know, trying to find some old notebooks of mine showing me my bad grades. Very embarrassing. But then she found this and she was like, do you want this? And this has Hannah Montana and stuff. If you can see here, I don't know, but yeah, Ishita Jain. I'm sorry, Ishita, if this is going to offend you in any way, but this is what I did. I wrote her name. And when I wrote her name, I was like, you know, I just wrote her name and I just encircled it that, you know, this is how I want to complete my engineering. And to be honest, after second, third sem, I never got supplies. I always got some or the other way, maybe the papers were easy or something was happening and I got passed in all my exams. I completed my graduation with good marks and to be honest, I had the most fun in my college life. Like the 4 years of my life, I was the happiest and that's what happened. And when my engineering was in the end, like 8th sem was over, the results were over, I again I just wrote here because she does not know that what happened, how I got inspired and that her story changed me a little to be something better. I wrote God bless her. Oops. So I wrote God bless her and then I wrote thank you God and I wrote one phase is complete. So when you have something in your mind, you don't know the ways to do it, you don't have the provisions to do it, you don't have support. But if it is in your mind that is like you are determined to do it, you will not even know. This particular thing will be in your subconscious mind and automatically the universe will answer, the God will answer, that higher power will answer and you will automatically fall in that path. That really happens because I have felt it. I will never share something which I have not experienced and I'm just blabbering about anything. But this actually happened to me. And the next very important thing, after I have completed my engineering, I was like, what to do now? Because I want to have certain things for my life. I have few goals. And again, on the same copy, I just wrote these things. If you can see, I have written job, car, shopping, laptop, and foreign trip. I had never ever planned to go out of my city and do some job or something. Automatically, I just got a job. I went to Bangalore. Obviously at that time a laptop of my own money was a big thing for me, so I got a laptop as well. Obviously my salary was good and shopping is like one of my dreams, and I'm not from a rich family, I'm from a middle class family, and to be honest these are dreams that you have from your childhood, and you know everybody should have it, whether you're rich, whether you are in the middle class family, but you should always feel like you have to be independent. You don't need to depend on your parents, because once you hit that independence wala, you know, mode, you feel a different kind of liberation in your life. Then is the moment when you actually find yourself, and that is what I did. And as I mentioned, I always, till now, I write what I want, and that is what I do. And I got my job and everything was just like my goals were getting accomplished. And I believe your subconscious mind, when you are determined in your conscious, your subconscious mind acts as dream catcher, I would say, and it will fulfill your dreams. But being said that, I'm not telling don't do hard work. It's just a way of living to be positive and never give up. You don't need to see for provisions, see for ways, see for support. If you want it, you will get it. Just be determined. I'm again repeating it, but yeah, that's all about it. And Ishita, thank you so much. I just want to say, because the way you lived your life at that time, I got really, really impressed. And I think that actually gave me a little hope that, you know, you can have fun. So guys, this is the end of the video. I just want to give this small message that always do what you want. Love to do what you want to do, and vice versa, just do what you love and always be yourself. And that's how you should live your life, with positivity, optimism and hope. And that is what I do, and I'm really glad that I'm living this life today where I am. I'm really happy, and I have a lot of things to achieve. Maybe that will come soon to me. I was like writing something for myself. So sometimes, you know, my sister tells me, you know, you seem to be sometimes very low, and you don't seem to be what you're portraying on your social media. And I'm being very honest to you guys on here, because sometimes, yes, I do get very low. I feel like, you know, nothing is working out for me, and I just write these quotes and I upload on my social media, not to tell you. Yes, obviously, if somebody is going to take benefit from that, I'll be very happy. But I just want to reassure myself. That's why I write it and I just post it in front of public. But you know, I also try to be this positive person, because obviously you cannot keep yourself together all the time. You will have days when you don't feel like doing anything, and that's okay if you're feeling that way, but you will get back on your track for sure. And this is what I wrote. We often get scared to stand alone and join the clan to blend in, but is it really worth it? You have to ask yourself. And you and I and everyone has one freaking life. I always say this. So do what you want, live how you want to, and love yourself beyond all. But have clarity that the journey is making you kind as well. So keep a check on that. And yeah, everything you will get for sure. And yeah, bye. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know by liking the video, commenting down in the comment section, and hit that notification bell icon so that you know whenever I upload a video. And do subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Till then, bye.